In this video, we showcase the servicing of our cranes at a shipyard, where two specialized technicians, assisted by the ship's crew, carry out the overhaul of the crane. Our focus will be on the replacement of the wire and drum, as this is the most challenging part of the process. We begin by detaching the auxiliary wire. It's relatively simple and easy to handle from the main deck. As you can see here, the wedge socket is disconnected from the load cell. Although it may take some time, the process is not overly complex. After the wire is pulled out of the socket, we can pull it through the limit switch and proceed to disconnect the main wire. The main wire also ends with a wedge socket, which is attached to the load cell on the lower part of the boom. Accessing this area can be challenging, but scaffolders are employed to overcome this issue. Technicians disconnect the wedge socket from the load cell, which will later be disconnected from the dead man pedi. Again, the wire needs to be removed from the wedge socket. Some effort may be required to persuade the socket to release the wire, but with a firm tap of a hammer, it will come loose. To prevent further unlaying of the strands, it's crucial to seize the wire before cutting it. This task should be entrusted to an experienced person. Before using the grinder to cut the wire, double check that the protective guard has not been removed by mistake. The guard should cover half of the cutting disc and be positioned between you and the material being cut. Once the wire is detached on both ends, the main block with three sheaves and six parts of line still remains. We need to pull the wire through that block as well. There's no special technique for this, we simply need to pull by hand. Fortunately, this section is only between the boom and the block, so it's not too long. However, the most challenging part is yet to come. We swing the crane boom to a better position and prepare to unspool the wire. Depending on the size and number of cranes, you may have kilometers of steel wire to pull. Therefore, it's unrealistic to expect to complete this task in a single day, especially if you're working offshore with a limited number of crew. As the wire is being pulled and laid down on deck, the crane operator must slowly slacken the wire, while the banksman gives clear instructions and closely monitors the drum. Failing to apply the appropriate tension can result in the wire getting tangled on the drum. Therefore, the crane operator's delicate touch and good cooperation with the banksman are crucial at this phase. Once the wires are finally pulled out of the drum and placed on the deck, the boom is returned to the boom rest position. It will remain in that position to allow work on the other crane components. This process can be time-consuming, which adds to the challenges faced by the technicians. Once all the components have been successfully detached from the drums, the team begins by removing the smaller drum using the shipyard's crane. The new drum is already waiting on deck, fully prepared for installation. The same procedure is followed for the larger drum, ensuring a smooth and efficient placement. The team of competent technicians complete the task relatively quickly due to their specialized training and extensive experience. Even they might lose count of the number of cranes they have overhauled over the years. While the new drums are being installed, the old ones are being prepared to be shipped to the workshop for comprehensive overhauling and future use elsewhere. Another crucial aspect of the replacement process is the replacement of all the hydraulic hoses. This task proves challenging as the hoses are difficult to reach, primarily located under the crane cabin. Approximately 120 hoses need to be replaced, making the job dirty, greasy and generally unpleasant. In addition to drum and hose replacement, the hydraulic oil tank is completely drained and thoroughly cleaned from the inside. This process allows access to the strainers and provides an opportunity to inspect the tank structure. Moreover, oil samples are taken for analysis before fresh oil is added to the tank.
Oil filter, hoses new, that's it?
Yeah.
Only he.
Okay, you can start.
After the hoses are reassembled and fresh oil is added to the tank, a comprehensive leak test is conducted. The crane operator starts the motors while the rest of the team inspects hoses and connections for any sign of leakage. Each hose and its respective connection are examined. To ensure a successful completion of the task, the technicians welcome assistance from the shipyard team, while both teams are supervised by the ship's crew.
All good?
Yes, sir.
All good here?
Yes.
Once no leaks are detected during the inspection, the team proceeds to the next step, which involves returning the wire to the drums. The new wire is delivered on a drum, which is then installed in an optimal position just below the tip of the crane boom. As the wire is pulled through the sheaves, it's carefully lubricated, ensuring smooth movement and minimizing friction. Eventually, the wire is passed to the technician responsible for handling the drum. This technician possesses the expertise to correctly attach the wire to the drum, following the detailed installation procedure outlined in the crane service manual. The team involved in the process comprises of a crane operator, technician positioned atop the crane, another technician on the deck, and their respective assistants. Effective communication and clear line of sight among all team members are vital for the successful execution of the task. The technician positioned on the drum ensures that the wire is laid on the drum correctly and as tightly as possible. This step is crucial to prevent the wire from penetrating through lower layers when weight is applied. Meanwhile, on the other end of the crane, the other technician focuses on maintaining tension in the wire as it is being laid on the drum. While it would be ideal to have a specialized wire tensioner, in this case the shipyard did not provide one. Therefore, the technicians devised their own old-school tensioner. This simple device is constructed using two wooden planks and a few bolts. By tightening the bolts, the tension is increased, and the friction between the wire and the wooden planks helps keep the wire tight. It is essential to continuously tighten the tensioner as the wire is pulled, as the steel wire easily cuts through the wood, reducing the friction and causing slack in the wire. Once the wires are completely spooled back on the drum and the necessary blocks are installed at the end, the team can proceed with the subsequent tests and evaluations to ensure the proper functioning of the crane. Once the crane is raised and swung out from the main deck, the technicians take their positions to conduct a series of tests. One technician joins the crane operator inside the cabin, while the other technician observes from the main deck. Clear instructions are provided to the operator on how to perform each test effectively. These tests encompass various aspects of crane's functionality, including wire spooling, counterbalance valves, boom extension, and testing all crane functions. Inside the cabin, the technicians compare the angles and radius displayed on the crane's computer system with the corresponding values on the load chart and inclinometer. If any discrepancies are identified, the technicians recalibrate the computer to ensure the accuracy of all angles and radius. Outside the cabin, the technicians closely monitor the performance of the counterbalance valve, hydraulic cylinders, slewing ring, gears, and other critical components. The auxiliary hook is used to lift a load, followed by the application of a significantly heavier load to assess the performance of the main wire. Although I forgot the exact weight of this load, it was substantial. To apply the maximum load on the crane, water bags weighing more than 54 tons are employed. The crane is swung away from the main deck and the water bags are filled accordingly. This important test is conducted under the supervision of a class surveyor, whose role is to ensure compliance with standards and regulations. Upon the successful completion of the tests, surveyor confirms the crane's suitability and hits his stamp on the documents, allowing crane to be put back in service. Since I made a separate video that covers the load test, I will not cover it here. Thank you for watching. This training and other videos on this channel are produced to educate the crew and all involved personnel. Feel free to use them in your training sessions.